Introduction to the Delta-wye Transformer Connection, Part 6E. In many areas of the power system, especially when we see transformers, we often see this type of an illustration for the Delta transformer connection. With it, we also see a dashed line that's pointing towards one side of that corner, okay? And that side where the dashed line is, that is always labeled as H1. And then we might have the other corner labeled as H2 and the third corner labeled as H3. Our goal for this video tutorial is to really understand how to read this type of a phasor diagram and make sense out of it, obviously. Okay, so first let's note a couple of things, right? To make our jobs a little easier, let's relabel this H1 as A, okay? Let's relabel this H2 as B, and this H3 as C. So the next question is, well, what's this dashed line here? This dashed line represents a line to ground voltage. So the next question that we might ask is, well, what line to ground voltage does it represent, right? Because we have several of them. So we have line to ground voltage VAG, which measures the voltage across line A and ground. BG represents the voltage between line B and ground, and CG, which represents the voltage across line C and ground. Since this dashed line is pointing towards this H1, or this corner of this triangle, this dashed line represents VAG, okay? Which means that if we put another dashed line here, this dashed line would represent the BG, and then this dashed line would represent VCG. Okay, it's very similar to the example that we did in the last tutorial. So let me again clean this up, and then let me make this smaller. Okay, so now that we've made that clear, the next question that comes up is, what does this represent here, right? This phasor, what does this represent? Does this phasor represent VAG, right? And if so, is it connected like this? Or does this phasor right here represent VAC? And if so, is it connected like that? Now, depending on what we choose or how we define these two phasor, that's going to be entirely different delta connection. We have to be very careful how we define these two legs of the triangle. Okay, so now we look back at our delta connection and we see that it's connected like this, right? And in the last video, we showed that the line-to-line voltage between line A and line B is equal to V phase A, right? Which is the voltage across winding A. So we immediately know that this line here, this represents V A, B, right? But VAB is also equal to V phase A, right? The voltage across the winding. So now we're going to put an arrow here because that's how we've defined it. Since the arrow is on this side, we're going to put a dot here to indicate the polarity side of this winding. Now that we've assumed that this side is V phase A, it becomes very clear that this side right here is VCA, and that is equal to V phase C, okay? And then this side right here, that is VBC, and that's equal to V phase B. Now, there are a couple of things that we could do to verify our assumptions. The first thing is, well, we know that this is VAB because the phasor starts from B and it goes to A, right? And it's opposite than how we've defined it, because how we've defined it, it's VAB, right? But the arrow is pointing in the opposite direction. Same thing over here. The arrow is pointing from A to C, but we've defined it as VCA. And then over here, it's from, the arrow is pointing from C to B, but we've defined it as VBC. The other thing that we can do is see how the polarity sides are connected. So V phase A, which is this winding here, this phasor here, the polarity side of V phase A is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase C, and the polarity side of V phase C is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase B. So this agrees with our transformer connection. The polarity side of V phase A is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase C. The polarity side of V phase B is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase A. And the polarity side of V phase C is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase B. So those are two major things that we can do to verify that the way that we've kind of defined everything and labeled everything actually makes sense. And that's how you analyze this type of a phasor diagram connection shown in many places of the power system. Now, if you find these videos useful, please subscribe by clicking on the button that's on the bottom right corner of your screen. By subscribing, you will be connected to video tutorials like this that make power systems intuitive and very easy to understand. This video was brought to you by GeneralPAC.com. Visit this website for additional video tutorials.